Hey guys, I'm Kelly Culhane, an ambassador of the Earpiece Save Your Hearing Foundation, a nonprofit organization dedicated to educating young people about protecting their hearing. I'm here to talk to you about something really important that I bet you don't know anything about. I'm talking about NIHL. That stands for noise-induced hearing loss. Listen to this. The World Health Organization estimates that 1.1 billion teens and young adults worldwide are especially at risk for noise-induced hearing loss. And one in five teens in the US will have this type of permanent hearing loss by the age of 19. They're talking about us. Why? One of the reasons is because we live in a pretty loud world, and we're also lucky enough to have these and these. We all love our phones, music, movies, messaging, the internet, but many of us are listening to our music way too loud and for way too long. That's taking a serious toll on our hearing, and for the first time, doctors are seeing young adults, even teens, with permanent hearing damage.
Some football teams even have a contest for the most enthusiastic fans who can create the loudest crowd roar. The current record is over 142 decibels. That sound level can cause instant hearing damage.
Because of these loud sounds all day long, our ears almost never get a rest. The result is high-frequency hearing loss that is progressive and permanent, but also entirely preventable. Did you know that each of us is born with 18,000 tiny hair cells in the inner part of each ear, and every time you expose yourself to really loud noise levels and listen for too long, you risk permanent damage to some of those hair cells? Once they become too damaged, they don't recover, and they can die. This causes high-frequency hearing loss, which especially affects your ability to hear soft sounds, like consonants, clearly. This means that speech will begin to sound more muffled and that you'll have difficulty hearing every part of the music you listen to, as well as other sounds. High-frequency hearing loss isn't noticeable at first. It's progressive and usually painless. You might not even realize you have a problem until it's very advanced. Once you do, this means that permanent hearing loss has already occurred. You might also be at risk for tinnitus, which is a ringing in the ears that can be permanent. This can't be fixed by hearing aids or turning up the volume, and it's just not enough for someone to talk louder. So what can teens do to protect their hearing?
Anything over 85 decibels can cause damage to your hearing. The higher the decibel level, the shorter the safe listening time. Any exposure over 140 decibels can cause instant hearing loss. There are three simple ways to prevent NIHL from happening. Turn the sound down. Walk away from the sound. Or wear protection.
The rule for listening to music is that the sound should be no more than 60% volume for no more than 60 minutes. And don't forget to always take breaks when listening to music to give your ears a rest. One way to test the safety of the volume is by making sure you can hear someone speaking to you in a normal voice at arm's length. If not, you need to turn the volume down. If you hear your favorite song in the car and you feel like cranking it up, go ahead and enjoy it. But then remember to turn the sound down afterwards to give your ears a break. If you're not sure what the sound level is, there are some great apps you can download to your phone to measure the decibel level anywhere you go. This will help you know if you're within safe listening levels or if you need to move away from the source of the sound. If you can't turn it down or walk away, you can protect your hearing by wearing earplugs. Music students are especially at risk for noise-induced hearing loss because of the many hours they spend playing instruments and performing. Here at Miami Palmetto Senior High, we have a premier band and orchestra program. One program of the Earpiece Save Your Hearing Foundation is called Protect-A-Band. This program is being implemented in Miami-Dade County Public Schools. Upon completion of a teacher training workshop, Earpiece Foundation provides each teacher's school with a comprehensive curriculum and all the necessary teaching materials to educate their students at no charge. The foundation also provides each teacher and every student in that teacher's band or orchestra class with free filtered earplugs for hearing protection. Miami Palmetto High School is leading the community in implementing this very beneficial program.
Great. You're going to want to hold it in your right hand next to the ear you're going to put it in. And with your left hand, you're going to want to reach over your head. And you want to pull your ear to straighten out your ear canal. And that DJ is going to blast the music. So what I want you to do is I want you to make sure that these sound waves are loud enough to reflect the loudness of the music that they're playing. Okay, ready? Have a seat and please straighten them out. Make them straight.
No.
You can't.
That's exactly right. You know why? Because they are permanently damaged. This is a very powerful demonstration for kids.
What do you think is the level at which hearing loss takes place? How many decibels? 1,000?
Once the teacher has taught the curriculum to their students, and the students know how to protect their hearing, Earpiece Foundation provides free, high-quality filtered earplugs to the teacher and every band and orchestra student. These earplugs protect the student's hearing by filtering out the harmful frequencies that cause noise-induced hearing loss while still allowing them to have a conversation, play their instruments, and perform. This helps them continue to participate in the wonderful music programs at Palmetto and protect their hearing at the same time.
Little part at the end that you're going to hold it right there. Okay, and then you're gonna reach down with your other hand, pull your ear back, a little bit back and up, so it straightens out the ear canal, and then you're gonna put them in, and then you let go. And it's gonna sound muffled at first. It's like glasses, you're gonna notice them, but if you wear them, you're gonna get used to them, you're not gonna notice them.
So now that you've gotten the earplugs, can you tell me what you think of them and would you recommend them to anybody else?
I definitely would recommend them to other people. Even if people don't aren't in band, I would recommend them. Because there are a lot of events that I go to, even school events or concerts and stuff like that, where I find myself using them just because it's louder than I feel is safe for me. So I do think that they're useful for everybody, not just musicians. And I use them all the time. I use them here in jazz band, in class, and at concerts, and also events where there's just really loud music.
I really love them. I use them every day in class, after school practices, and at pep rallies. They do a really nice job of blocking out the sound, and they're great.
The earpiece earplugs that I got from the foundation are really well. I used them a lot, and so I might even recommend it to my brother, who's also in college studying music, so he can save his ears, and I can save mine, because I like to hear, especially good music.
I really enjoy using the earplugs, especially when it gets loud in class. It's nice to be able to use them to protect my hearing while also doing what I love. I would definitely recommend them to other kids because hearing's important, so thumbs up.
The program has been very beneficial to the instrumental classes here at Miami Palmetto Senior High School. The students and I have learned a great deal about noise-induced hearing loss and its effects for us today and tomorrow. The curriculum put forth by the Earpiece Foundation and the Protect Your Band program has been very informative. By teaching us the way to use earplugs correctly, we've been able to expose the students to how to practice and in certain environments what they can do to help protect their hearing. I strongly recommend that music teachers in this system and around the country use this curriculum to help inform their students of the dangers of noise-induced hearing loss in a music classroom, but not only that, outside the music classroom, in the environments that are much louder than we've experienced in years past. It is with great, great privilege that I endorse this program, and I hope that everybody, the students, the parents, and the audiences are informed of noise-induced hearing loss so that way we can move forward and enjoy the music for years to come.
We have our whole lives ahead of us, and we need our hearing. So have fun, but don't forget to take a few simple steps to protect your hearing. Help spread the word and enjoy a lifetime of music and listening.